This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Europe is a continent that comprises the westernmost part of Eurasia. Europe is bordered by the Arctic Ocean to the north, the Atlantic Ocean to the west, and the Mediterranean Sea to the south, to the east and southeast. Europe is generally considered as separated from Asia by the watershed divides of the Ural and Caucasus Mountains, the Ural River, the Caspian and Black Seas, and the waterways of the Turkish Straits. Yet the non-oceanic borders of Europe, a concept dating back to classical antiquity, are arbitrary. The primarily physiographic term continent, as applied to Europe, also incorporates cultural and political elements whose discontinuities are not always reflected by the continent's current overland boundaries. Europe covers about 10,180,000 square kilometers, 3,930,000. Fall of the Western Roman Empire, during the migration period, marked the end of ancient history and the beginning of an era known as the Middle Ages. The Renaissance, humanism, exploration, art, and science led the Old Continent, and eventually the rest of the world, to the modern era. From this period onwards, Europe played a predominant role in global affairs between the 16th and 20th centuries. European nations controlled at various times the Americas, most of Africa, Oceania, and the majority of Asia. The Industrial Revolution, which began in the United Kingdom at the end of the 18th century, gave rise to radical economic, cultural, and social change in Western Europe, and eventually the wider world. Both world wars were largely focused upon Europe, contributing to a decline in Western European dominance in world affairs by the mid-20th century as the United States and Soviet Union took prominence during the Cold War. Europe was divided along the Iron Curtain between NATO in the west and the Warsaw Pact in the east, until the revolutions of 1989 and fall of the Berlin Wall. European integration led to the formation of the European Union, a political entity that lies between a confederation and a federation. The EU originated in Western Europe but has been expanding eastward since the fall of the Soviet Union in 1991. The currency of most countries of the European Union, the euro, is the most commonly used among Europeans, and the EU's Schengen area abolishes border and immigration controls among most of its member states. Contents: 1. Name. 2. Definition. 21. Contemporary definition. 22. History of the concept. 221. Early history. 222. Modern definitions. 3. History. 31. Prehistory. 32. Classical antiquity. 33. Early Middle Ages. 34. High and Late Middle Ages. 35. Early Modern Period. 36. 18th and 19th centuries. 37. 20th century to the present. 4. Geography. 41. Climate. 42. Geology. 43. Flora. 44. Fauna. 5. Politics. 6. List of states and territories. 7. Economy. 71. Economic history. 8. Demographics. 81. Ethnic groups. 82. Migration. 83. Languages. 9. Culture. 91. Religion. 10. See also. 11. Notes. 12. References. 13. Sources. 14. External links. Name. Further information: Europa Mythology. Reconstruction of Herodotus. World Map. 450 BC in Classical Greek Mythology. Europa Ancient. Contemporary definition. Clickable map of Europe, showing one of the most commonly used continental boundaries. Key, blue, states which straddle the border between Europe and Asia. Green, states not geographically in Europe, but closely associated with the continent. Alb, Andorra, Austria, Azer, Belarus, Belg, BIH, Bulgaria, Channel Is, UK, Croatia, Czech Rep. Denmark, Estonia, Finland, France, GIB, UK, Germany, Georgia, Greece, Hungary, Iceland, Ireland, Italy, MAN, UK, SMAR, Kazakhstan, Kosovo, Latvia, Leech, Lithuania, Lux, Mac, Malta, Moldova, Mon, Mont, Nether, Norway, Svalbard, Nor, Poland, Portugal, Romania, Russia, Serbia, Slovakia, Slo. Spain, Sweden, Switz, Erland, Turkey, Ukraine, United Kingdom, Far, DK, VAT, Armenia, Cyprus, Greenland, DK, ADR, IATICC, Arctic Ocean, Baltic Sea, Aegean Sea, Barents Sea, Bay of Biscay, Black Sea, Caspian Sea, Celtic Sea, Greenland Sea, Baffin Bay, Gulf of Cadiz, Ligurian Sea, Mediterranean Sea, North Atlantic Ocean, North Sea, Norwegian Sea, Strait of Gibraltar. The prevalent definition of Europe as a geographical term has been in use since the mid-19th century. Europe is taken to be bounded by large bodies of water to the north, west and south. Europe's limits to the Far East are usually taken to be the Urals, the Ural River, and the Caspian Sea. To the southeast, including the Caucasus Mountains, the Black Sea and the waterways connecting the Black Sea to the Mediterranean Sea, islands are generally grouped with the nearest continental land. landmass, hence Iceland is generally considered to be part of Europe, while the nearby island of Greenland is usually assigned to North America. Nevertheless, there are some exceptions based on socio-political and cultural differences. Cyprus is closest to Anatolia or Asia Minor, but is usually considered part of Europe both culturally and politically, and currently as a member state of the EU. Malta was considered an island of North Africa for centuries. Europe, as used specifically in British English, may also refer to continental Europe exclusively. History of the concept. Early history. The first recorded usage of Europe as a geographic term is in the Homeric hymn to Delian Apollo, in reference to the western shore of the Aegean Sea as a name for a part of the known world. It is first used in the 6th century BC by Anaximander, and Hecateus Anaximander placed the boundary between Asia and Europe along the Phasis River, the modern Rioni in the Caucasus, a convention still followed by Herodotus in the 5th century BC. Herodotus mentioned that the world had been divided by unknown persons into three parts: Europe, Asia, and Libya, Africa, with the Nile and the river Phasis forming their boundaries, though he also states that some considered the river Don, rather than the Phasis, as the boundary between Europe and Asia. Europe's eastern frontier was defined in the 1st century by geographer Strabo at the river Don. The Book of Jubilees described the continents as the lands given by Noah to his three sons. Europe was defined as stretching from the Pillars of Hercules at the Strait of Gibraltar, separating it from North Africa, to the Don, separating it from Asia. The convention received by the Middle Ages and surviving into modern usage is that of the Roman era, used by Roman era authors such as Posidonius, Strabo, and Ptolemy, who took the Tanais, the modern Don River, as the boundary. The Lady of Vinča, Neolithic pottery from Serbia. The term Europe is first used for a cultural sphere in the Carolingian Renaissance of the 9th century. From that time, the term designated the sphere of influence of the Western Church, as opposed to both the Eastern Orthodox churches and to the Islamic world. A medieval T&O map from 1472 showing the three continents as domains of the sons of Noah: Asia to Sem Shem, Europe to Iapeth Japheth, and Africa to Chamham. A cultural definition of Europe as the lands of Latin Christendom coalesced in the 8th century, signifying the new cultural condominium created through the confluence of Germanic traditions and Christian Latin culture, defined partly in contrast with Byzantium and Islam, and limited to northern Iberia, the British Isles, France, Christianized Western Germany, the Alpine region, and northern and central Italy. The concept is one of the lasting legacies of the Carolingian Renaissance. Europa often figures in the letters of Charlemagne's court scholar Alcuin. Modern definitions. Further information. Geopolitical divisions of Europe and Core Europe. Depiction of Europa Regina, Queen Europe. In 1582, the question of defining a precise eastern boundary of Europe arises in the early modern period, as the eastern extension of Muscovy began to include northern Asia throughout the Middle Ages and into the 18th century. The traditional division of the landmass of Eurasia into two continents, Europe and Asia, followed Ptolemy, with the boundary following the Turkish Straits, the Black Sea, the Kerch Strait, the Sea of Azov, and the Don. Ancient Tanais. But maps produced during the 16th to 18th centuries tended to differ in how to continue the boundary beyond the Don Bend at Kalach na Danu, where it is closest to the Volga, now joined with it by the Volga-Don Canal, into territory not described in any detail by the ancient geographers. Philip Johann von Strahlenberg in 1725 was the first to depart from the classical Don boundary by drawing the line along the Volga, following the Volga north until the Samara Bend, along Obshchi Syrt, the drainage divide between Volga and Ural, and then north along Ural Mountains, introducing the convention that would eventually become adopted as standard. The mapmakers continued to differ on the boundary between the Lower Don and Samara well into the 19th century. The 1745 atlas published by the Russian Academy of Sciences has the boundary follow the Don beyond Kalach as far as Serafimovich before cutting north towards Arkhangelsk. While other 18th to 19th century mapmakers such as John Carey followed Strahlenberg's prescription to the south, the Kuma-Manich Depression was identified circa 1773 by a German naturalist, Peter Simon Pallas, as a valley that, once upon a time, connected the Black Sea and the Caspian Sea, and subsequently was proposed as a natural boundary between continents by the mid-19th century. There were three main conventions, one following the Don, the Volga-Don Canal and the Volga, the other following the Kuma-Manich Depression to the Caspian and then the Ural River, and the third abandoning the Don altogether, following the Greater Caucasus watershed to the Caspian. The question was still treated as a controversy in geographical literature of the 1860s, with Douglas Freshfield advocating the Caucasus crest boundary as the best possible, citing support from various modern geographers. In Russia and the Soviet Union, the boundary along the Kuma-Manych Depression was the most commonly used as early as 1906. In 1958, the Soviet Geographical Society formally recommended that the boundary between the Europe and Asia be drawn in textbooks from Baitarotskaya Bay, on the Kara Sea, along the eastern foot of Ural Mountains, then following the Ural River until the Mugajer Hills, and then the Emba River, and Kuma-Manych Depression, thus placing the Caucasus entirely in Asia and the Urals entirely in Europe. However, most geographers in the Soviet Union favored the boundary along the Caucasus crest, and this became the standard convention in the later 20th century. Although the Kuma-Manych boundary remained in use in some 20th century maps, History Main Article, History of Europe, Prehistory Main Article, Prehistoric Europe, Stonehenge in the United Kingdom, Late Neolithic from 3000-2000 BC, Homo erectus georgicus, which lived roughly 18,000-7000 BC in Greece and the Balkans, probably influenced by earlier farming practices in Anatolia and the Near East. It spread from the Balkans along the valleys of the Danube and the Rhine, Linear Pottery Culture, and along the Mediterranean coast, Cardial Culture, between 4500 and 3000 BC. These Central European Neolithic cultures developed further to the west and the north, transmitting newly acquired skills in producing copper artifacts in Western Europe. The Neolithic period was characterized not by large agricultural settlements but by field monuments, such as causewayed enclosures, burial mounds and megalithic tombs. The corded ware cultural horizon flourished at the transition from the Neolithic to the Chalcolithic. During this period, giant megalithic monuments, such as the megalithic temples of Malta and Stonehenge, were constructed throughout Western and Southern Europe. The European Bronze Age began c. 3200 BC in Greece with the Minoan civilization on Crete, the first advanced civilization in Europe. The Minoans were followed by the Mycenaeans, who collapsed suddenly around 1200 BC, ushering the European Iron Age. Iron Age colonization by the Greeks and Phoenicians gave rise to early Mediterranean cities. Early Iron Age Italy and Greece from around the 8th century BC gradually gave rise to historical classical antiquity, whose beginning is sometimes dated to 776 BC, the year the first Olympic Games. Classical antiquity. Main article, classical antiquity. See also, Ancient Greece and Ancient Rome. The Parthenon in Athens, 432 BC. Ancient Greece was the founding culture of Western civilization. Western democratic and rationalist culture are often attributed to Ancient Greece. The Greek city-state, the polis, was the fundamental political unit of Classical Greece in 508 BC. Cleisthenes instituted the world's first democratic system of government in Athens. The Greek political ideals were rediscovered in the late 18th century by European philosophers and idealists. Greece also generated many cultural contributions, in philosophy, humanism and rationalism under Aristotle, Socrates and Plato, in history with Herodotus and Thucydides, in dramatic and narrative verse, starting with the epic poems of Homer, in drama with Sophocles and Euripides, in medicine with Hippocrates and Galen, and in science with Pythagoras, Euclid and Archimedes. In the course of the 5th century BC, several of the Greek city-states would ultimately check the Achaemenid Persian advance in Europe through the Greco Persian Wars, considered a pivotal moment in world history, as the 50 years of peace that followed are known as Golden Age of Athens, the seminal period of ancient Greece that laid many of the foundations of Western civilization. The Roman Empire at its greatest extent in 117 AD. Greece was followed by Rome, which left its mark on law, politics, language, engineering, architecture, government and many more key aspects in Western civilization, expanding from their base in Italy beginning in the 3rd century BC. The Romans gradually expanded to eventually rule the entire Mediterranean basin and Western Europe. By the turn of the millennium, the Roman Republic ended in 27 BC, when Augustus proclaimed the Roman Empire. The 2 centuries that followed are known as the Pax Romana, a period of unprecedented peace, prosperity, and political stability in most of Europe. The empire continued to expand under emperors such as Antoninus Pius and Marcus Aurelius, who spent time on the empire's northern border fighting Germanic, Pictish and Scottish tribes. The empire began to decline in the 3rd century, particularly in the West. Christianity was legalized by Constantine I in 313 AD after 3 centuries of imperial persecution. Constantine also permanently moved the capital of the empire from Rome to the city of Byzantium, which was renamed Constantinople in his honor. Modern-day Istanbul in 338 380 AD Christianity became the sole official religion of the empire in 380 AD, and in 391-392 AD, the Emperor Theodosius outlawed pagan religions. This is sometimes considered to mark the end of antiquity. Alternatively, antiquity is considered to end with the fall of the Western Roman Empire in 476 AD, the closure of the pagan Platonic Academy of Athens in 529 AD, or the rise of Islam in the early 7th century AD. Early Middle Ages. Main articles, Late Antiquity and Early Middle Ages. See also, Dark Ages Historiography and Age of Migrations. Europe c. 650. Charlemagne's Empire in 814. Constantinople's First Golden Age. He established a legal code that forms the basis of many modern legal systems, funded the construction of the Hagia Sophia, and brought the Christian Church under state control. Roland pledges fealty to Charlemagne. Holy Roman Emperor. Delegations of Croats and Serbs at Byzantine court of Basil I from the 7th century onwards, as the Byzantines and neighboring Sassanid Persians were severely weakened due to the protracted, centuries-lasting and frequent Byzantine-Sassanian wars, the Muslim Arabs began to make inroads into historically Roman territory, taking the Levant and North Africa and making inroads into Asia Minor in the mid-7th century AD. Following the Muslim conquest of Persia, Islam penetrated into the Caucasus region. Over the next centuries, Muslim forces took Cyprus, Malta, Crete, Sicily and parts of southern Italy between 711 and 720. Most of the Iberian Peninsula was brought under Muslim rule. Germanic and Slav tribes established their domains over Western and Eastern Europe respectively. Eventually the Frankish tribes were united under Clovis. Main articles, High Middle Ages, Late Middle Ages, and Middle Ages. See also, Medieval Demography. The period between the year 1000 and 1300 is known as the High Middle Ages, during which the population of Europe experienced significant growth, culminating in the Renaissance of the 12th century. Economic growth, together with the lack of safety on the mainland trading routes, made possible the development of major commercial routes along the coast of the Mediterranean and Baltic Seas. The growing wealth and independence acquired by some coastal cities gave the maritime republics a leading role in the European scene. Tancred of Sicily and Philip II of France. During the Third Crusade 1189-1192, the Middle Ages on the mainland were dominated by the two upper echelons of the social structure, the nobility and the clergy. Feudalism developed in France in the early Middle Ages and soon spread throughout Europe. A struggle for influence between the nobility and the monarchy in England led to the writing of the Magna Carta and the establishment of a parliament. The primary source of culture in this period came from the Roman Catholic Church through monasteries and cathedral schools. The Church was responsible for education in much of Europe. The papacy reached the height of its power during the High Middle Ages. An East-West Schism in 1054 split the former Roman Empire religiously, with the Eastern Orthodox Church in the Byzantine Empire and the Roman Catholic Church in the former Western Roman Empire. In 1095, Pope Urban II called for a crusade against Muslims occupying Jerusalem and the Holy Land. In Europe itself, the Church organized the Inquisition against heretics in Spain. The Reconquista concluded with the fall of Granada in 1492, ending over 7 centuries of Islamic rule in the Iberian Peninsula. In the east, a resurgent Byzantine Empire recaptured Crete and Cyprus from the Muslims and reconquered the Balkans. Constantinople was the largest and wealthiest city in Europe from the 9th to the 12th centuries, with a population of approximately 400,000. The empire was weakened following the defeat at Manzikert and was weakened considerably by the sack of Constantinople in 1204. During the Fourth Crusade, although it would recover Constantinople in 1261, Byzantium fell in 1453 when Constantinople was taken by the Ottoman Empire. The sacking of Suzdal by Batu Khan in 1238, during the Mongol invasion of Europe in the 11th and 12th centuries, constant incursions by nomadic Turkic tribes, such as the Pechenegs and the Cuman Kipchaks, caused a massive migration of Slavic populations to the safer, heavily forested regions of the north and temporarily halted the expansion of the Rus state to the south and east. Like many other parts of Eurasia, these territories were overrun by the Mongols. The invaders, who became known as Tatars, were mostly Turkic-speaking peoples under Mongol suzerainty. They established the state of the Golden Horde with headquarters in Crimea, which later adopted Islam as a religion and ruled over modern-day southern and central Russia for more than three centuries after the collapse of Mongol dominions. The first Romanian states principalities emerged in the 14th century, Moldova and Wallachia previously. These territories were under the successive control of Pechenegs and Cumans from the 12th to the 15th centuries. The Grand Duchy of Moscow grew from a small principality under Mongol rule to the largest state in Europe, overthrowing the Mongols in 1480 and eventually becoming the Tsardom of Russia. The state was consolidated under Ivan III the Great and Ivan the Terrible, steadily expanding to the east and south over the next centuries. The Great Famine of 1315-1317 was the first crisis that would strike Europe in the late Middle Ages. The period between 1348 and 1420 witnessed the heaviest loss. The population of France was reduced by half. Medieval Britain was afflicted by 95 famines, and France suffered the effects of 75 or more in the same period. Europe was devastated in the mid-14th century by the Black Death, one of the most deadly pandemics in human history, which killed an estimated 25. For the moment, as illustrated by Giovanni Boccaccio in the Decameron 1353, it was a serious blow to the Roman Catholic Church and led to increased persecution of Jews, foreigners, beggars and lepers. The plague is thought to have returned every generation with varying virulence and mortalities until the 18th century. During this period, more than 100 plague epidemics swept across Europe. Early modern period. Main article, early modern period. See also, Renaissance, Protestant Reformation, Scientific Revolution, and Age of Discovery. The School of Athens by Raphael. 1511. Contemporaries such as Michelangelo and Leonardo da Vinci Center are portrayed as classical scholars. The Renaissance was a period of cultural change originating in Florence and later spreading to the rest of Europe. The rise of a new humanism was accompanied by the recovery of forgotten classical Greek and Arabic knowledge from monastic libraries, often translated from Arabic into Latin. The Renaissance spread across Europe between the 14th and 16th centuries. It saw the flowering of art, philosophy, music, and the sciences, under the joint patronage of royalty, the nobility, the Roman Catholic Church, and an emerging merchant class. Patrons in Italy, including the Medici family of Florentine bankers and the popes in Rome, funded prolific Quattrocento and Cinquecento artists such as Raphael, Michelangelo, and Leonardo da Vinci. Political intrigue within the Church in the mid-14th century caused the Western Schism. During this 40-year period, two popes, one in Avignon and one in Rome, claimed rulership over the Church. Although the schism was eventually healed in 1417, the papacy's spiritual authority had suffered greatly. Martin Luther 1483-1546 initiated the Protestant Reformation. The Church's power was further weakened by the Protestant Reformation 1517-1648, initially sparked by the works of German theologian Martin Luther, an attempt to start a reform within the Church. The Reformation also damaged the Holy Roman Emperor's influence, as German princes became divided between Protestant and Roman Catholic faiths. This eventually led to the Thirty Years' War 1618-1648, which crippled the Holy Roman Empire and devastated much of Germany, killing between 25% and 40% of its population in the aftermath of the Peace of Westphalia. France rose to predominance within Europe. The 17th century in southern, central and eastern Europe was a period of general decline. Central and eastern Europe experienced more than 150 famines in a 200-year period between 1501 and 1700. From the 15th to 18th centuries, when the disintegrating Khanates of the Golden Horde were conquered by Russia, Tatars from the Crimean Khanate frequently raided eastern Slavic lands to capture slaves. Further east, the Nogai Horde and Kazakh Khanate frequently raided the Slavic-speaking areas of Russia, Ukraine and Poland for hundreds of years, until the Russian expansion and conquest of most of northern Eurasia, i.e. Eastern Europe, Central Asia and Siberia. Meanwhile, in the south, the Ottomans had conquered the Balkans by the 15th century, laying siege to Vienna in 1529. In the Battle of Lepanto in 1571, the Holy League checked Ottoman power in the Mediterranean. The Ottomans again laid siege to Vienna in 1683, but the Battle of Vienna permanently ended their advance into Europe, and marked the political hegemony of the Habsburg dynasty in Central Europe. The Renaissance and the new monarchs marked the start of an age of discovery, a period of exploration, invention, and scientific development among the great figures of the Western scientific revolution of the 16th and 17th centuries were Copernicus, Kepler, Galileo, and Isaac Newton. According to Peter Barrett, it is widely accepted that modern science arose in the Europe of the 17th century towards the end of the Renaissance, introducing a new understanding of the natural world. In the 15th century, Portugal and Spain, two of the greatest naval powers of the time, took the lead in exploring the world. Christopher Columbus reached the New World in 1492 and Vasco da Gama opened the ocean route to the east in 1498, and soon after the Spanish and Portuguese began establishing colonial empires in the Americas and Asia. France, the Netherlands and England soon followed in building large colonial empires with vast holdings in Africa, the Americas, and Asia. 18th and 19th centuries. Main article, Modern History. See also, Industrial Revolution, French Revolution, and Age of Enlightenment. Napoleon's retreat from Russia in 1812. Napoleon's Grande Armée had lost about 500,000 men. The Age of Enlightenment was a powerful intellectual movement during the 18th century promoting scientific and reason-based thoughts. Discontent with the aristocracy and clergy's monopoly on political power in France resulted in the French Revolution and the establishment of the First Republic, as a result of which the monarchy and many of the nobility perished during the initial reign of terror. Napoleon Bonaparte rose to power in the aftermath of the French Revolution and established the first French Empire that, during the Napoleonic Wars, grew to encompass large parts of Europe before collapsing in 1815 with the Battle of Waterloo. Napoleonic rule resulted in the further dissemination of the ideals of the French Revolution, including that of the nation-state, as well as the widespread adoption of the French models of administration, law, and education. The Congress of Vienna, convened after Napoleon's downfall, established a new balance of power in Europe centered on the five great powers, the UK, France, Prussia, Austria, and Russia. This balance would remain in place until the revolutions of 1848, during which liberal uprisings affected all of Europe except for Russia and the UK. These revolutions were eventually put down by conservative elements and few reforms resulted. The year 1859 saw the unification of Romania, as a nation-state, from smaller principalities. In 1867, the Austro-Hungarian Empire was formed, and 1871 saw the unifications of both Italy and Germany as nation-states from smaller principalities. Urban growth, mass employment, and the rise of a new working class. Reforms in social and economic spheres followed, including the first laws on child labor, the legalization of trade unions, and the abolition of slavery in Britain. The Public Health Act of 1875 was passed, which significantly improved living conditions in many British cities. Europe's population increased from about 100 million in 1700 to 400 million by 1900. The last major famine recorded in Western Europe, the Irish Potato Famine, caused death and mass emigration of millions of Irish people in the 19th century. 72 world wars and an economic depression dominated the first half of the 20th century. World War I was fought between 1914 and 1918. It started when Archduke Franz Ferdinand of Austria was assassinated by the Yugoslav nationalist Gavrilo Princip. Most European nations were drawn into the war, which was fought between the Entente powers France, Belgium, Serbia, Portugal, Russia, the United Kingdom, and later Italy, Greece, Romania, and the United States, and the Central powers Austria-Hungary, Germany, Bulgaria, and the Ottoman Empire. The war left more than 16. Stalin's leadership, confiscations of grain by the Soviet authorities contributed to the Second Soviet Famine, which caused millions of deaths. Surviving kulaks were persecuted and many sent to gulags to do forced labor. Stalin was also responsible for the Great Purge of 1937-38, in which the NKVD executed 681,692 people. Millions of people were deported and exiled to remote areas of the Soviet Union. Economic instability, caused in part by debts incurred in the First World War and loans to Germany, played havoc in Europe in the late 1920s and 1930s. This and the Wall Street crash of 1929 brought about the worldwide Great Depression, helped by the economic crisis, social instability, and the threat of communism. Fascist movements developed throughout Europe, placing Adolf Hitler of Nazi Germany, Francisco Franco of Spain, and Benito Mussolini of Italy in power in 1933. Hitler became the leader of Germany and began to work towards his goal of building rebuilding Greater Germany. Germany re-expanded and took back the Saarland and Rhineland in 1935 and 1936. In 1938, Austria became a part of Germany following the Anschluss later that year. Following the Munich Agreement signed by Germany, France, the United Kingdom and Italy, Germany annexed the Sudetenland, which was a part of Czechoslovakia inhabited by ethnic Germans, and in early 1939, the remainder of Czechoslovakia was split into the Protectorate of Bohemia and Moravia, controlled by Germany, and the Slovak Republic at the time. Britain and France preferred a policy of appeasement, bombed and burned out buildings in Hamburg, 1944-45. With tensions mounting between Germany and Poland over the future of Danzig, the Germans turned to the Soviets, and signed the Molotov-Ribbentrop Pact, which allowed the Soviets to invade the Baltic states and parts of Poland and Romania. Germany invaded Poland on 1 September 1939, prompting France and the United Kingdom to declare war on Germany on 3 September, opening the European theater of World War II. The Soviet invasion of Poland started on 17 September and Poland fell soon thereafter on 24 September. The Soviet Union attacked the Baltic countries and later, Finland. The British hoped to land at Narvik and send troops to aid Finland, but their primary objective in the landing was to encircle Germany and cut the Germans off from Scandinavian resources. Around the same time, Germany moved troops into Denmark. The Phoney War continued in May 1940. Germany attacked France through the Low Countries. France capitulated in June 1940. By August, Germany began a bombing offensive on Britain, but failed to convince the Britons to give up. In 1941, Germany invaded the Soviet Union in the Operation Barbarossa on 7 December 1941. Japan's attack on Pearl Harbor drew the United States into the conflict as allies of the British Empire and other Allied forces. The Big Three at the Yalta Conference in 1945, seated from the left, Winston Churchill, Franklin D. Roosevelt, and Joseph Stalin. After the staggering Battle of Stalingrad in 1943, the German offensive in the Soviet Union turned into a continual fallback. The Battle of Kursk, which involved the largest tank battle in history, was the last major German offensive on the Eastern Front in 1944. British and American forces invaded France in the D-Day landings, opening a new front against Germany. Berlin finally fell in 1945, ending World War II. In Europe, the war was the largest and most destructive in human history, with 60. Later called by Winston Churchill an Iron Curtain. The United States and Western Europe established the NATO alliance, and later the Soviet Union and Central Europe established the Warsaw Pact. The two new superpowers, the United States and the Soviet Union, became locked in a 50-year-long Cold War, centered on nuclear proliferation. At the same time, decolonization, which had already started after World War I, gradually resulted in the independence of most of the European colonies in Asia and Africa. In the 1980s, the reforms of Mikhail Gorbachev and the Solidarity Movement in Poland accelerated the collapse of the Eastern Bloc and the end of the Cold War. Germany was reunited, after the symbolic fall of the Berlin Wall in 1989, and the maps of Central and Eastern Europe were redrawn once more. European integration also grew after World War II. The Treaty of Rome in 1957 established the European Economic Community between six Western European states, with the goal of a unified economic policy and common market. In 1967, the EEC, European Coal and Steel Community, and Euratom formed the European Community, which in 1993 became the European Union. The EU established a parliament, court and central bank and introduced the euro as a unified currency in 2004 and 2007. More Central and Eastern European countries began joining, expanding the EU to its current size of 28 European countries, and once more making Europe a major economical and political center of power. Geography. Main article, Geography of Europe. Relief map of Europe and surrounding regions. Europe makes up the western fifth of the Eurasian landmass. It has a higher ratio of coast to landmass than any other continent or subcontinent. Its maritime borders consist of the Arctic Ocean to the north, the Atlantic Ocean to the west, and the Mediterranean, Black, and Caspian Seas to the south. Land relief in Europe shows great variation within relatively small areas. The southern regions are more mountainous, while moving north the terrain descends from the high Alps, Pyrenees, and Carpathians, through hilly uplands, into broad, low northern plains, which are vast in the east. This extended lowland is known as the Great European Plain, and at its heart lies the North German Plain. An arc of uplands also exists along the northwestern seaboard, which begins in the western parts of the islands of Britain and Ireland, and then continues along the mountainous, fjord-cut spine of Norway. This description is simplified. Sub-regions such as the Iberian Peninsula and the Italian Peninsula contain their own complex features, as does mainland Central Europe itself, where the relief contains many plateaus, river valleys and basins that complicate the general trend. Sub-regions like Iceland, Britain, and Ireland are special cases. The former is a land unto itself in the Northern Ocean, which is counted as part of Europe, while the latter are upland. Areas that were once joined to the mainland until rising sea levels cut them off. Climate. Main article, Climate of Europe. Biomes of Europe and surrounding regions. On around the same latitude, January temperatures in Berlin average around 8.